Welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to create this solar eclipse in Adobe Illustrator. In this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to create a sun with a corona on the edge, then create a shadow of the moon in front of it to create a solar eclipse like this. So stay tuned to see in detail how I made this eclipse, and don't forget to press the subscribe button if you are new to this channel. Here, I have prepared a 1920 by 1080 pixels document. You can create a document of the same size like I did if you want to follow what I did in this tutorial. But remember, this document must be in RGB color mode. If you use CMYK color mode then the result will be much different from what I show here. So don't forget to set your document with RGB color mode. The first thing we're going to do is create the background. Use the rectangle tool and create a rectangle the same size as the artboard. Give it a dark color that describes the dark sky during a solar eclipse. In this tutorial, the result will depend on the background color. So if you use a different color then the eclipse effect will not be as expected. First, open the color picker panel to give it a color. You can open it by double-clicking on the fill box in the toolbar. Just double-click to open it. And now, I want you to pay attention to this panel, because it will affect the result of the eclipse that we're gonna create. To create a color for the background like I mean, place the color slider, on the color spectrum, between the red and the orange color. Or, 15% on the hue. Now, in the color field, choose a color that is almost black but not solid black in a position like this. Because if you choose solid black then the eclipse will not occur. Or you can give the S value, or saturation with 88%. And B, or black at 6%. So now we've got an almost black orange instead of a solid black. At first glance it will look like a black color because that's what we want, but we still get orange color on it. And that is very important step if you want to do a technique like this. And if you skip that step then you will not get the eclipse effect as shown in this video. Now, we have finished this background with a very dark orange color. I recommend to lock this background by going to the object menu. Lock. Selection. And the next step is to create the solar. To create this solar we need two circles. Create the first circle using the ellipse tool, with the same size as the artboard height, which is 1080 by 1080 pixels. Place it in the center of the artboard using the vertical and horizontal align tools. And give it a solid black color. But first, remove the stroke color by click the stroke box on the toolbar, and click the none button below it. After that, double-click the fill box to open the color picker panel. In the color field, click, and drag until it touches the bottom of the color field. Or you can easily fill in the value of B, or black with 0%. In this way we can get solid black color by filling black value with 0%. And finally, click OK. Now, you can see the difference between the background color, which is a dark orange, and this circle which is solid black. Next, create the second circle, in the same way as before. But this time with a size of 550 by 550 pixels. Also place it in the middle of the artboard. And give it pure white color. But this time, I want to color it through the color swatches. Open the color swatches in the window menu. And just click on the white color that's already there. From these two circles, we will create solar light. First, select these two circles. Then go to the object menu. Blend. And click make. After that, back to the object menu. Blend. And blend options. Change smooth color to specified distance. And to make the transition from black to white smoother, just change the value to 2 pixels. Click OK. I think this is pretty smooth. And the next step is the magic part. And with just a few clicks, these two circles become the sun. While this blended circle is still selected, go directly to the window menu. And search for transparency to open the transparency panel. On the transparency panel, click the blending mode drop-down menu. And, choose color dodge. And boom! From this. To this. And this is the magic part which I meant earlier. You can see the black color on the big circle becomes completely transparent, and the white on the small circle stays the same color. And the amazing part, is this color transition between white and black, if we give color dodge to it, it will produce a bright effect. That's because the color dodge works by producing a bright effect on the result color, by reducing the contrast between the base color and the blend color, resulting in saturated midtones and blown highlights. But remember that the document must be in RGB color mode. As I mentioned earlier, if you use CMYK color mode, the results will not be the same. You can watch some of my previous tutorials about this color dodge on the card above. And the white, yellow, and orange colors that resemble the color of the sun are produced by the background color, which is a dark orange color. That's why the background color is very influential for the final result. If you use a different color for the background, it will produce a different sun color. And the color result are only determined by the background color, not the color of the object that has been given a color dodge. The next step is to create another circle, but this time create it manually. Activate the ellipse tool on the toolbar and draw a circle freely. Hold down the shift key on the keyboard to create a perfect circle. Place it in the center using the align tool horizontally and vertically. After that, open the swatches panel and give the default color black and white gradient. Open the gradient panel and change the gradient type to radial gradient. Next, change the blending mode to color dodge. After that, scale the circle lengthwise like this, by using the bounding box. Press and hold the alternate key on the keyboard to scale it. Scale it again on the side so that it touches the edge of the artboard. In that way, we get the effect of the solar corona. You can also make more than one, and rotate them randomly. After you have finished this step, we just need to create the last circle, to create the shadow of the moon blocking the sun, so we will get the solar eclipse. Activate the ellipse tool. Create a circle with a size of 555 by 555 pixels. Place it in the center using the align tools. Give it a solid black color that is in the swatches. What do you think about this solar eclipse tutorial? Write your opinion in the comment. You can watch another similar tutorial that uses color dodge on the card above. Or, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you're new to this channel. Leave me a like, and I really appreciate it if you share this video to your community. See you in the next tutorial.